Give a round of applause for all the LLJ and Lakewood High School players. Sixth graders, come up. While the sixth grade choir is arriving on stage, I want to welcome everybody to our fall choir concert tonight. It's good to see a lot of familiar faces as we're coming in, and a lot of new faces too that I'm excited to meet after the concert's over tonight. My name is Adam Johnson. I am the choir teacher at both Lakewood Oswego Junior High School and now Lakewood Junior High School as well. This is my third year in the district, first year teaching all choir all day, and that's why I'm a very happy human right now. So I'm very excited to share your students' music with you tonight. And I wanted to tell you briefly, the concert side of your program, it's called Better Together. When our whole district staff met in this auditorium right before school started, our superintendent's message for the year was that we are better together, that there's no rivalry between the two sides of the lake, and that when you put two great things together, you get something even better. And I love that my job this year has me going to both sides of the lake and making music with these two sides of the lake. And as you can see behind me, these are the sixth graders from both sides of the lake making beautiful music together. They sound great individually, but they sound amazing together. So I hope that over the course of this evening, you hear that we are better together. So this is the sixth grade choir. I'll hand it over to them. I'm going to have students come down and introduce each of the pieces as we go on, and we hope you enjoy.
Thank you. It's time to spice things up with our final number, Kantar, a piece written in the style of traditional Cuban salsa music. The text of Kantar simply translates to sing a joyful song, sing alleluia, sing a song with one voice, and pairs well with a rhythmically infectious melody. We hope to express through this song the joy we feel when we make music for those around us.
Thank you. Go, Go Down Moses is a traditional spiritual and describes the events in the book of Exodus in which Moses is commanded to demand the release of Israelites from slavery in Egypt. As with most spirituals, the text has double meaning. A biography of Harriet Tubman quotes Tubman as saying she used Go Down Moses as one of two code songs that slaves could use to communicate when fleeing Maryland. In the context of American slavery, going down is referring to the concept of down the river, the Mississippi, where slaves' conditions were notoriously worse off. Tonight, we try to sing this song in the same determination used by slaves when fleeing for their freedom.
Thank you.
Irish folk song, with lyrics taken from a poem written by William Butler Yeats. The song tells the story of a young man who meets a beautiful girl in Sally Gardens, but then loses her due to an unknown circumstance. This arrangement of the classic song, sung mostly in unison, allows us to sing beautiful legato.
Thank you.
truly have no meaning but are meant to simulate a tribal sound. We enjoyed spending time in class listening to the piece with a critical ear to come up with a storyline for the song. What was the song saying? If the lyrics were to be translated into English, what would they be? In our imagination, this piece tells the story of a boy who has lost his way in the woods and is trying to get home, only to be met with constant setbacks as he wanders aimlessly beneath the stars. What do you think?
Joshua 5th Battle of Jericho is a traditional spiritual believed to have been composed by slaves in the early 19th century. On paper, the text tells the biblical story of when Joshua led the Israelites against Canaan. However, like many other spirituals, the words may also be alluding to eventual escape from slavery. Tonight, our arrangement of this gospel standard takes on more of a funky layback and swing style.
Jericho, Joshua hit the battle of Jericho, and the walls came tumbling
We're going to combine the LJ 8th grade choir and the Lakeridge 7th 8th grade choirs for one piece tonight.
Candy Hair is from a series of songs by composer James Papoulis called Sounds of a Better World, a series of songs focusing on children, which examines their world and how small steps can be made to improve it. We sing this song tonight as a call for a better future where all children can have the opportunity to grow up in a world and develop into caring, responsible adults without hardship defining their childhood.
Calling.
Alright, I'm going to talk for a minute while the 7th graders silently, we're learning that word, silently, stand up in our chairs and come up onto the risers for our last number. I want to thank everybody for coming to our concert tonight. We have one song left, and I have a couple things that I wanted to say before we get there. Please do not talk on the risers, please. Thank you. Yes, I want to thank everybody for coming here tonight. This is why we do this. We sing so that we can sing for all of you and sing together. It's very special to all of us, and we're very happy that we're able to do it every single day together. I think I have the best job ever, just be able to come into school and make music with your kids. It's absolutely the best. So thank you, thank you, thank you. Before we go into our last song, we have a couple of parents who are going to be walking through the audience with a couple of donation bins. We are raising funds right now in the choir world because we have a group called Encore at LOJ. It's a group of 45 audition singers who are going to be going to Disneyland over spring break in March to perform in the parks over one day and then to also take part in a studio recording workshop where they go into the Disney studios and they work with a composer and an arranger and a sound producer, and they get a chance to go into the parks and see what it's like to be a professional in a lot of different career paths in music. So we're raising funds to kind of help with that trip that's happening in March. So if you, if you're able to give at all, we'd be very, very, very appreciative. I want to say thank you to our amazing administration for allowing us to do what we do. My crazy, amazing colleagues at both buildings that I am so lucky to work with. Zach Schwabach at LO High School, Bill Campbell here at Lake Ridge High School, Isaac Zuckerman, Darian Douglas, and Joe Tyson at LOJ, and Brandon Sauce, Chris Beardy, and Christy Single at Lake Ridge Junior High School. No matter what music discipline your kids are getting a great education and having an awesome time doing it. So, I'm really, really proud to work alongside all of them. I want to thank all the parents who are driving their students here tonight. And as they silence themselves, I'm going to thank all the students up here for sharing your voices with us tonight, sharing your voices with me every single day. It is, it's just the best. So thank you, thank you, thank you for your hard work. And I'm happy we get to do this 3 more times throughout this year. Our last song is We Are the World, a song that I'm assuming everybody in here has heard once or twice before. At the very end of the song, I'm going to turn around and welcome you all to sing the last chorus with us so we can kind of end the night singing in unison together, kind of a prayer for peace for the world. I chose the song at the beginning of the year when there were a couple bad news items, and as the year went on, that list kind of kept getting longer and longer and longer. And then when I came in and saw these faces every single day, it just seemed more and more appropriate to be singing this song. To kind of show that this is the future, and we are the future, and that we can make the world a better place. So please sing with us at the end, and there are some soloists in this one, and please save your applause for those soloists until the very end. I'll recognize them at the end. I knew I forgot something. One last thing. After the concert tonight, consider taking you and your family to Yodelish behind Lake Oswego High School. For the rest of their business day, which ends at 10 p.m., they're donating 20% of their funds back to the choir department. And you say that you're there supporting the choir. So if you got a sweet tooth, like I know a couple people behind me do, consider going to get some frozen yogurt tonight. That's all I have. Here we go.